Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 24th August. On the front page you have government response to downturn with steps to boost growth. So controversial surcharge on foreign portfolio investors, which was announced in the budget in July, has been withdrawn now. But increased surcharge will be applicable to those earning over 2 crore a year. Then violation of CSR rules, corporate social responsibility rules, also will not be treated as a criminal offense, has been announced by the government. And government will front load 70,000 crore of capital infusion in public sector banks. Then below you have Coimbatore under security blanket. So it is said six Lashkar-e-Toyba suspects have believed to have intruded into Tamil Nadu. So security blanket has been brought over Coimbatore in Tamil Nadu. And this is center steps in to control oil prices. So because of rain in onion growing states, there are concerns about hike in prices of onion. So center has taken steps to control onion prices. So it has asked the police from all the neighboring states to take action to prevent artificial shortage in Delhi. And this is Delhi scores lowest on water management. So this is composite water management index, which is an assessment by Niti Aayog on how states and union territories manage their water. So Delhi has finished at the bottom of this index. On page 4, you have the continuation of front page news, that is capital, that is Delhi, ranks last in Niti Aayog's assessment of water management. It is said Delhi failed to give data on 12 indicators and reported nil on few. So you should know that Niti Aayog index is actually based on response from the states. So if states do not give data, then they are not getting the points there. So then their ranking goes down. Then on page 9, you have triple talaq. Supreme Court issues notice to center. So there are batch of petitions challenging the criminalization of pronouncements of triple talaq, which are before the Supreme Court. So it has issued notice to the center on the matter. And this is 13 states, union territories improve their water management practices. So this is regarding Niti Aayog's water management index ranking, which we saw Delhi ranks last, and Gujarat tops the ranking for the second time. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is sentiment booster. So this is regarding how government has rolled back some measures and has listened to the feedback to give a boost to the economy. It's on the same lines as the front page news, that you know, the for high net worth individuals, the surcharge which was imposed, that has been relaxed, that was affecting foreign portfolio investments and all other measures on corporate social responsibility, etc. Then this is shallow draughts. So this is regarding Jammu and Kashmir. It says India needs to remind President Trump of the real basis of its claim to Jammu and Kashmir. So how India has to assert itself that what is the reason why Jammu and Kashmir entirely belongs to India. So we have to assert them that strongly on the basis of the facts. So that's what is spoken of in this editorial. And then the lead article is an end to arms control consensus. So this is regarding end to the New START policy. So START stands for Strategic Arms Reduction Treaty, which is a bilateral treaty between USA and Russia. So the New START ends in 2021 and it will leave the arsenals of the two major nuclear powers unencumbered by any threat. So the arms control measures are, are either being the, we have seen how both the countries have withdrawn from intermediate range nuclear force treaty. In October 2018, President Trump had announced so. And now we are seeing another treaty being ending soon. So this leaves the space open for arms race. So arms control consensus is ending, is highlighted in this article, which is an important issue. And this is letting the pearl on the Silk Road shine brighter. So this is regarding the pearl Silk Road in China. So how India and China can work together and let the pearl on the Silk Road shine brighter. So this is regarding Dunhuang City, which has been witness to multiple interactions and mutual learning between China and India. So this is about a specific point in India-China relations. Then on the op-ed page on Saturdays, you have Ground Zero coverage, and today it is regarding the deadly landslides of Malabar. So as Malabar faces up to rain-related tragedies, the debate shifts to whether ecologically sensitive areas should be free of human interventions. So plight of the displaced in the hills of North India, North Kerala is highlighted here. On page 13, you have FATF group blacklists Pakistan. So this is regarding Financial Action Task Force. So the fear which was there that in the Asia-Pacific group of FATF in Canberra, Pakistan would be blacklisted has come true. Pakistan has been blacklisted, which is rightly target, you know, because Pakistan has been supporting terror financing. So this FATF Financial Action Task Force is a group on money laundering and terror financing, against fighting against the two. So this is there. So task force regional panel says too few safeguards exist against terror financing. So that's why Pakistan has been blacklisted. And this is corruption, nepotism reined in, Prime Minister. So people's mandate was given not just to run government but to build a new India is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi said as such while addressing in the Indian community at UNESCO headquarters in Paris. It's also regarding India-France relations. On international page, you have, with Amazon forest on fire, Brazil faces global backlash. So EU is deeply worried. Even Germany and Norway have shut down, may shut down a conservation initiative here. So the concerns have been raised because with the new government in power in Brazil, under the new prime minister, new president, Brazil has seen burnings, patches in Amazon forest, which is a huge stretch and which is considered as the lungs of the world, lungs of the earth. So they are on fire now. So commercial activity is being supported as against environmental concerns, which has resulted in global backlash here. And this is China announces new tariffs on $75 billion worth US imports. So President Trump has now vowed quick response and has told companies to find alternatives. Then on business page you have FM steps in to accelerate auto demand. So we have been seeing slowdown in the auto sector, automobile sector in the sales. So now Finance Minister has announced a slew of measures to boost demand in the auto sector and also to reduce uncertainty as such. So here you can see the government is deciding to now that it will replace old vehicles with new ones. So that is there. Then also higher depreciation of 30% up from 15% for all vehicles purchased from now till March 2020 would be allowed. And also it says that, you know, steps would be taken to, like you can see, deferment of higher one-time registration fees has been put in place, then ban on purchase of new vehicles lifted for all government departments. The government departments will purchase new vehicles. So this is how it is helping the auto industry. Then this is move to decriminalize CSR violations welcomed. So companies can now utilize the funds in an effective way without any fear, because corporate social responsibility norms violation will not be a criminal offense. And this is upfront capital for public sector banks to bolster loan growth. So you can see, so we have seen on front page how 70,000 crore of capital infusement would go to public sector banks. So this its move is said to be capable of releasing liquidity to the tune of 5 lakh crore rupees, because then banks will be able to lend to a larger extent. Then on page 16, you have government takes steps to ease doing business. So it expedites payments and GST refunds for micro, small and medium enterprises, which is an important step to facilitate doing business, because otherwise the funds of micro, small and medium enterprises were trapped with the government and they were not released, which affected their functioning. And this is angel tax relief brings much needed respite for startups. So a large number of startups had received notices from the tax department, but now they have been provided this relief. So this is much needed for the startup sector. So you can see fast tracking GST refunds in 30 days and dedicated cells to address tax problems are also being proposed that will help ease business environment further. So these are the important headlines. Thank you.